Hi everyone, my name is Alexander Clarke. This is a second installment of my Road to the Britain video blog. We're currently 10 weeks out from the UKBFF Midlands and 12 weeks out from the UKBFF British Championships. Today I'm going to train legs and show you what I typically do. I didn't have a training partner today, which kind of makes the workout atypical in that I had to use some different techniques. I had to throw a couple of extra sets in here and there, and I had to use some different intensifiers rather than forced reps, negatives, etc. I had to have a contingency plan to continue using HIT training without a spotter. And there's a wonderful display of athleticism thrown in randomly. Anyway, yeah, I started out with dynamic stretching. I went from a sequence of a lunge into an inner thigh stretch, directly into a hamstring stretch, then into another lunge, and I followed that sequence all the way down the length of the gym, and that's just a really good way to warm your legs up in a very kind of holistic fashion. I then did a little bit of dynamic stretching and static stretching on my lower back. After that, I went into leg extensions. I warmed up with a very light weight for 15 reps, into a moderate weight for 8 to 10 reps, into a heavy weight, which was just below my weight for my main set, for 6 reps. You may notice that when I'm doing leg extensions, I actually sit fairly upright on the seat. Now what this does is it makes the hip more flexed. As you know, the rectus femoris flexes the hip. It attaches actually to the hip, unlike the other three quadriceps. So it makes the muscle shorter, hence creating a greater contraction at the top of the movement. So this is beneficial, however, it does mean that you can't use as much weight. So what I tend to do is I'll do my set in that really strict style, and then I'll sit back onto the pad so that the muscle is actually lengthened and it makes the exercise easier for just a couple more reps. That intensifies the set and enables me to get a couple more at the end when I failed. After I've done my main set bilaterally, I do a set unilaterally, and at the end of the set, again, I go from being sat upright in the seat to being sat back, and I get a couple of extra reps that way. Then I give myself negatives whereby I use both legs to bring the weight to the top, but I use one leg, the working leg, to lower the weight. After leg extensions, I move on to squats. I did a warm-up set with one plate, 15 reps, two plates, 8 reps, and three plates, 6 reps. I then moved on to my main set with four plates, and I got 7 reps with that. I did a second set with three plates aside, and I got 9 reps. I actually used a closer stance to target more quads and more outer quad on that one, whereas the wider stance that I used for the first set targets more glutes, inner thighs, I find. After squats, I moved on to hack squats. Now, I actually felt a really weird pain in my knee on squats, and it didn't feel like a good sign. I moved on to hack squats, and that pain was actually intensified. So I knew that it definitely wasn't a good idea to carry on trying to go heavy. So what I did is I just stuck to two plates, which was normally my first warm-up set, and I aimed for 20 reps. I think I actually got 21 out or something like that. It wasn't really relevant. I just wanted to do a high rep set just so that I could still stimulate the muscle without injuring myself. And sometimes, guys, that's actually the best thing to do. If you feel a pain, like something's gonna go, don't risk it. Just stimulate the muscle in a different way, or maybe even, you know, go and get yourself checked out and do it, you know, do the workout on a different day. Don't let your ego get you injured. So that pretty much sums up quads and wraps it up for part one. Part two is going to be coming soon, which is hamstrings and inner thighs, two areas which I find that a lot of bodybuilders and fitness bikini figure competitors train less than optimally and often neglect. And I hope you can learn something from that workout, like hopefully you've learned something from this workout too. So as usual, you can contact me on Alexander Clarke Personal Training, that's my Facebook page. You can email me on alexclark1@btinternet.com. My website is www.alexanderclark.net, and on Twitter it's @BigAlexClark. Thanks a lot for watching, guys, and I hope you enjoy the rest of the video.
This is Country Jeff. Howdy, Country Jeff.
Howdy, Paul.
Are you doing some machine squatting?
Oh, yes.
Build that motherfucking legs.